Joshua Bergara. What's going on, buddy? Grabbing some tea before I head out with the Insta360 Go 2, where I'm going to be doing a bit of a real-world camera test using this new tiny little camera. One of my favorite parts about the camera is actually the stuff that it comes with. We're going to go through all of that a little bit later. But let's just say for now, I'm using the case, which is also a tiny little tripod to get this particular shot.
Yeah, keep an eye in the corner because all of the footage that you are just seeing right now was taken on this small little camera. But before I get you back to watching videos on this little Insta360 Go 2, let's talk about the device itself. Actual footage from this camera will be sprinkled throughout this section, and then I'll have a little montage at the end. By the way, for more real-world camera tests like this, make sure you hit the like button on this video and then subscribe to my channel for more. Now, we're going to talk about some upgrades from the original, and the first thing that you should know is that the Go 2 now records at a higher resolution of 1440p, which will lead to higher quality captures all around. It also no longer has a limit to its video recording, whereas the original would only go for like 30 seconds with every button press. Now, this tiny camera has that single button that you can press to start recording videos from basically anywhere thanks to the included accessories. These are accessories that are very similar to the ones in the original Insta360 Go, but they have been updated in this second edition. And let me tell you, they're exactly the upgrades that needed to happen. What used to be a novelty camera that basically always required a smartphone to be the best tool it can possibly be, now is a camera that can, more or less, stand on its own. Quite literally, because we're going to start off with the new case. The last case was just a charging case that connected to smartphones via USB-C or Lightning ports. Now it's a charging case that includes some controls for actually using the camera in and out of the magnetic cradle. That's right, you have way more control over both the capture of content and also where you can put the camera because this case comes with a couple of important extras. First off, you can use the camera in this particular fashion, just angling the camera properly for typical vlogging purposes.
And combined with the inherently super wide angle lens and the flow state stabilization, the Insta360 Go 2 turns into one of the easiest and smallest effective vlogging machines.
It gets even better though because the case has a couple of pull-out legs here to make it into a tiny tripod, and you can stand it basically anywhere when you don't have the other accessories on hand. But yet, even if you did have something like a switch pod or even a general tripod on hand, you could actually use the case's tripod mount to put the camera on there as well. Just with this case alone, the possibilities have increased exponentially. The charging case itself is charged by USB-C, but for the most part, you'll be connecting it to your smartphone wirelessly to download down all of your content. And let me get one quick part out of the way. I actually don't have any metrics to tell you about battery life, but I will say that I have never felt like the camera was going to die on me during any of the filming sessions you're seeing in this video, because the camera was back in this case often enough that it would be topped back up. And the case itself was more than capable of lasting throughout any of these sessions. One thing I will admit though is that I had the Insta360 Go 2 connected to my iPhone 12 Pro Max for a long time shift capture, but it died in the middle of that because it was both recording and trying to relay its viewfinder to the smartphone. So the combination of all of those high-level things that this camera can do, doing them all together definitely drained the battery really quick. The other great part of this case is that it will connect to the camera whether or not it's in the charging cradle, making it a remote control when you have the camera mounted somewhere else. It really does seem like Insta360 is doing its best to minimize the need for smartphones to be part of the capturing experience. You will get the most control out of having a connected smartphone because it provides you with a viewfinder and you can change up the settings in the various modes. But once you do change up those settings, the camera will remember all of those settings accordingly when you're just using it by itself. And of course, you'll need the smartphone for getting all of the footage down and editing it, but we'll get to that later. For now, let's just say that the smartphone will be needed for at least the initial setup, but once you figure out what settings are best for you, you can mostly rely on the case to switch up the modes and to hit the record button, even if a little bit away from the camera itself. Seriously, it's just a huge improvement to be able to confirm what mode you're in and change it if needed without requiring a smartphone or even any guesswork. Now the rest of the accessories open up even more creative avenues. The first one is actually pre-installed, but it signals a proper shift in the durability of the Go 2. Screwed onto the lens of the camera is a guard that seals the camera for better water resistance. You no longer have to get a specific case for submerging the camera in water anymore because the Go 2 now has a higher IP certification out of the box. So long as you have the guard screwed onto the lens, that means that right out of the gate you can do some underwater work or just keep things simple like I did and get some unique shots of myself making some tea. Given the size of the camera, it's literally the only camera I have that can fit in a cup and get me this unique angle. Now for the various mounts. They're actually very similar to the ones that were included with the original Go, but there are improvements here and there. You might be familiar with the necklace mount, which I'm actually wearing right now. I'll show you in a second. You can wear it underneath clothing, and the powerful magnet from the camera keeps it mounted even through a shirt or a sweater. I can actually get it through both layers of clothing that I have on right now. This is the main way, and I can just barely show you in the frame right now, this is the main way that you can get those POV or point of view shots that literally show your perspective. Now, as far as where to mount it under your clothing, it will be something that you learn through experience. But let me just tell you that while I originally thought it would be good to have it around chest height, it was actually better to have it lower down, basically to where my elbows would be and where my hands would naturally end up. Otherwise, I was going out of my way to like raise items up to the line of the camera, or I was tilting downward to make sure I was framing things right. A little bit lower, right below the chest area, it's actually pretty good. The next accessory is a clip of sorts, which would work on like a backpack strap or on the bill of a cap. This is one that I use the least because the other mounts gave me the capabilities I already needed. And the last accessory included with my unit was the sticky mount, or more officially called the pivot stand. It has a sticky pad that adheres strongly to surfaces like glass, which naturally made it the correct mount to use in my car for some time-shifted capture. Yeah, I don't have like a pet to put the camera on, and I don't do any action sports, so this was like the most action-oriented thing that I could capture outside of the typical vlog situations. So I got my footage, which means it was time to get it onto the smartphone. It's through the same Insta360 app that you might have used with some of their other products, so things mostly felt familiar. Now, because I prefer to edit everything in my actual video editor as much as possible, I would go into the shots and maybe chop them up if I had too much fat to cut, and then keep the footage at 16:9 aspect ratio because I could always crop in myself if I wanted to do vertical video. That's not to discredit the editing tools that are in the Insta360 app. As a matter of fact, this app here helps the Insta360 Go 2 fulfill yet another great use scenario. It's actually the easiest way, so far for me, to capture vertical video for social media networks like TikTok and Instagram and YouTube Shorts. You can set the camera to always capture 9:16 video, which means it'll crop in the middle of the sensor automatically. Or you can do what I do and just record everything in Pro Video all the time, because it allows you to set videos for 9:16 in the app if you decide you want to have it for like your TikToks and social media videos. The Pro Video mode just gives you more control in general after the actual recording, so I think it's just best to record all the time using that mode. And if you are going to end up working from the smartphone all the time, having that level of control makes it easier for you to create that vertical video before importing all of that footage into the TikTok editor or a smartphone editor of your choosing. But like I said, for videos like this, I already said that it's better for me to just keep everything at 16:9 and then I will edit it myself on my computer. With that in mind, I selected all of my footage already captured at the settings I wanted and let the iPhone in this case perform the export. It might take a while, but I did get quite a few clips. And with that, let's go ahead and pop it into my editor and I'll give you a montage of my footage. Honestly, the best part about this new Go 2 is that you can literally use it as a vlogging camera. Now, there are going to be some trade-offs. On the one hand, you have this case that gives you some control. It gives you a nice little tripod so you can do some pretty nice shots of like time lapses, or even put the camera down and be the star of your own vlog, which I always tell people to do. Or you could just leave it in the case, open it up, and then point it at yourself, get some easy vlog shots. And with 1440p resolution, you can get some good quality capture as long as the lighting is good. And yeah, it's a nice tiny little vlogging machine, as long as you don't care too much about things like viewfinders and having the absolute best quality possible. It's all about convenience with this thing when you look at it as just a vlogging machine. Otherwise, if you look at it as an action cam, the accessories that come with the Insta360 Go 2 are all the things that you might want in order to get those really interesting different perspectives that only a tiny little camera like this can get. So what are my ultimate thoughts? I honestly applaud Insta360 for improving their Go camera to such an extent that it's the perfect device to just throw in a bag or in a pocket in case you find yourself needing something small or something, let's say, totally simple. While there are a couple of trade-offs just by nature of this camera being so little and not having a screen, you might be estimating your framing and you have to be prepared for that mostly action camera style of footage. You can always change it to the narrow angle, and it does help literally narrow things down a bit and it reduces distortion on the sides, but don't expect to do things like tight framing or even have much depth of field between your subjects. Low light won't be this camera's forte, but that's mostly expected. And the only other main gripe that I have is that there's no expandable storage on here, so you'll likely be doing footage dumps from the 32GB that is pre-installed. As you can see here, it says, no space, I'm already out of it. But the amount of things you can do with this camera are bolstered both by the accessories and the Insta360 software, so that you can do time shifts if the camera itself is moving, or time lapses if the camera will be standing still. And of course you can get photos too, but you might already have a phone that can easily do that job. Which brings me to my real thought on this little camera. It's the perfect second camera to the smartphone that's already in your pocket. For photos and highest quality video capture, you can easily just take out any recent smartphone and use that. But for the unique angles, the special situations, and the POV footage, it's great that Insta360 have upgraded not only the quality of the capture in the Go 2, but also increased its practical use cases. That way, it's the camera you can easily rely upon for your vertical videos, your time lapses, your action moments, and literally your perspective, whenever you feel like sharing those moments. Hobbyist vloggers have a very viable tool in the Insta360 Go 2, alongside the phone they're probably already using to make videos anyway. And I think together, this makes for a pretty fun combination. To check out the Insta360 Go 2 for yourself, you can follow the link in the description below. For more real-world camera tests with cameras like this, and of course with smartphones and beyond, make sure you subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. With all of that said, I'm gonna go ahead and call it on this video. Thank you so much for watching. Please take care of yourselves and each other, and enjoy your tea, everybody.